Dropzilla, people know about different stuff, it's basically everybody calls it Drop.
Well, basically, I've been playing Tekken since, I'd say, like, Tekken 1, casually, you know, when I was, like, younger. Just, you know, just button mashing, having fun with the game, basically. I've been playing all of the Tekkens, really, but I haven't really gotten into them too seriously, except for some Tekken 6, Tekken VR. Around this time, I started coming to the arcades, started playing a lot. And, say about maybe around, like, January, beginning of the year or so, that's when I started playing. So, as far as my rank, my skill level, I'm working on it. It's not the best. I don't think it's the worst. You know, it's always debatable depending on who you ask. That's pretty much it. I think, I would say I'm the average Tekken player. The average, just above casual, but not pro just yet. But we're working on it. My character in Tekken 6 VR is Lili. It's like my favorite character. I don't know. It's kind of clicked together for some reason. I use a couple other characters, but when I'm at the arcades, I stick specifically just to Lili. I don't know. I like her moves. She's a good character. She's solid. She's one of the best. So, you know, I can't really argue that the character's messed up. You know, she's great. It's my favorite character. You know, the more I play, the more I kind of see where they're coming from with the tier list as far as Lili being top tier. She's a great character, you know, but at my skill level, I don't think I'm really able to see everything that makes her the best just yet. So, you know, she's, as far as I've seen, the damage is ridiculous. She's a great character. I don't have any complaints. The best. Anyway, the best. New York City is the best in Tekken. East Coast Tekken is the best in Tekken. I don't know what else to really say about it. I hear about California. I see California, but it's about the East Coast.
What's your thoughts on West Coast Tekken?
Never heard of.
More representation, in my opinion, as far as, you know, getting our names out there. There's only a select few places that have Tekken. They're kind of way out there. Everybody has to travel to the same basic spot to play. So everybody's familiar with each other. I think the skill level is great up here. I'm surprised by some of the stuff I see on a daily basis when I'm playing against even lower level players.
I think I might have a couple rivals.
I don't know if they know they're my rivals, but there's a couple guys, you know, like most of them, the ones that I first started playing against, like Bloodhawk and the game. When I first came here, I was getting my ass whipped. You know, I was free. Well, I don't know, I might still be free. But when I first started playing against them, those are the guys that I kind of thought were like, okay, these guys must be the best. So when I get better, these are the guys that I want to beat. But then I also have other rivals. I have another person that plays Lili up here, Sorrow. I have yet to actually play against him, but that hopefully it happens soon. But I want to play him in a couple rounds. That's one of my rivals, but I kind of see him as an ally also. Then, you know, there's also the pro players that you want to get up to that level and you want to beat them. So, of course, you know, I got my eye on everybody, to be honest. I want to beat everybody. So you can call everybody my rival, but it's all in good fun. Well, you know what? Since I started getting onto the Tekken scene, the only real rivalry that I've seen between New York or even the East Coast against anybody would just be strictly West Coast. It's usually East Coast versus West Coast, you know, Tupac and Biggie. I don't know why, you know, that transfers to Tekken, but whatever. You know what? Jersey, I consider more of an ally than a rival. I got a lot of respect for the Jersey players, but all the people, the ones that come out here to play are great guys. I learned a lot from playing against them. I had fun in my matches. I don't have nothing bad to say about Jersey players. But I'm coming for them too. I think there's a rivalry between East Coast and West Coast, from what I've seen anyway. What I've read on the internet forums at Tekken Guy Box. When I speak to people about the East Coast or the West Coast, you know, look on YouTube. They've got videos. They call us out. We call them out. You know, personally, a little random for me, but, you know, their style is their style. You know what? Tekken 6 for the console, that's probably the only game that I've tried to hold off on for this long without just going nuts trying to play it. I think the reason that I even came to the arcades in the first place is because I was so excited for Tekken 6. The fact that it's coming for 360 is great. I mean, I'm not a big fan of console rivalries, you know, console wars. I don't see the point. If you have the money, buy it. If you don't want it, don't buy it. If you're not letting me play it. I don't really care. It's fine. But I'm really happy it's coming to 360. I think it's going to expand the audience. I think the live community, in my opinion, is a little better than the 360, I mean, the PS3 community. Personal opinion, don't shoot me on that, you know. But the fact that it's good online, the fact that, you know, people are going to be able to play it all over against each other, you might see something you never know. There might be some guy that's way out there in some place you've never heard of who's the best. Maybe, you know, we'll hear from him or something. As far as international competition goes, I've heard a lot about the Philippines. I'm not sure how great they are. To be honest, I kind of stick within East Coast and American Tekken. I hear a lot of, I would hear a lot of good things about Korea, but since I don't know the players personally, I tend to connect with them a little less. I just watch the video and see what they do. And, you know, take notes every once in a while. I hear there are a lot of Korean players that are, you know, the best, of course. But, you know, it's Korea, can you say? You know, as far as giving advice to people who are just starting out with Tekken or even have been playing for a while and kind of hitting the wall, so to speak, I don't know. I think you should just find somebody that you can read that'll help you evaluate your playing style and see what you're doing. Or even if you can do it on your own, maybe watch your matches if you have the cameras available. I think that's something else you might see a little bit more of when the console gets released, when you have a little bit more availability to play the game. Basically, when you're, you know, sitting at home, there's a lot less pressure than you would have playing here. Like, learning on the arcade for $1 a game can get kind of stressful. I would say just relax. It's a game. You know, just treat it like a game. That's all. Just have fun with it. If you don't have fun, you really shouldn't be playing. DropOne is a writer from Queens. DropOne goes by the alias Dropzilla because he's the biggest monster. But he's ridiculous. You should see this guy in here sometimes. Nah, basically, my name is Dropzilla, DropOne. They call me that because I'm a writer. I tag Drop. I tell people that's not a good the first of my kind. That's where the one comes from. Zilla comes because I'm big, I'm a monster. You know, I terrify the land of Chinatown every once in a while. But,
what the hell is
I'm just a dude that loves Tekken. What can I say?